Vision of the Ancient War and the Angelic War of the Last Days. Many people may be confused about certain stages of Satan being cast out. The first stage was when Lucifer rebelled against God and lost his position as the anointing cherub that covers. Then he convinced one-third of the angelic beings to rebel with him. There'll be a big war in heaven and he lost. He and all the fallen ones were cast out from the third heaven, and they were limited only to the second heaven realm. The earth became a part of this realm, and was now under his control and influence. Therefore, when Yeshua said, "I saw Satan fall from heaven like lightning," he was referring to the time when Satan was expelled from the third heaven. Now we are approaching a very grievous time when the second epochal war of heaven is going to occur. It will happen in the second spiritual realm when the angels of God will push Satan and his army out of heaven and down to the physical realm of the earth. Satan will be limited and will be cast out from the dimensional space of heaven. He will no longer have access to Heavenly Father, nor be allowed again to accuse anybody before God. And I heard a great voice saying in heaven, "Now has come the salvation and power and the kingdom of our God and the authority of his Christ, for the accuser of our brothers is cast down who accused them before our God day and night. Woe to the inhabitants on the earth and in the sea, for the devil came down to you, having great wrath, knowing that he has but a little time." And indeed he will have a little time to prepare for the battle of Armageddon. Many people know about this battle and about the end of days, but not many understand that this battle will not be battle of people against God. It does not make sense that anyone in their right mind would think that could battle against Yeshua. The true battle will be between Lucifer and his fallen ones, with all the demonic hordes and half-breeds. It will be their battle and will not involve people. Many may wonder what role we have in this battle. Let me put this way. By the time of the Battle of Armageddon, people who will follow the beast and receive his mark will no longer be human being eligible for salvation. They will lose their genetic connection to the human race, and their souls will become dissociated from the body. The moment they accept the mark of the beast, their souls will lose their tie with body, and they will not be able to reverse this by reciting their choice of the mark. It is likely that the soul will come under complete control of demonic entities, which will take over their bodies. Then they will face eternal damnation. This will be the second death, a spiritual death. The person will no longer be human, but now a host of demons. And I saw three unclean spirits like frogs come out of the mouth of the dragon, and out of the mouth of the beast, and out of the mouth of the false prophet. For they are spirits of demons, working miracles, which go forth to the kings of the earth and of the whole world, to gather them to the battle of the day, the great day of God Almighty. Behold, I am coming as a thief. Blessed is the one who watches and keeps his garment, lest he walk naked and they see his shame. And he gathered them into a place called in the Hebrew tongue Armageddon. And I saw heaven open, and behold, a white horse, and he sitting on him was called Faithful and True, and in righteousness he judges and makes war. And his eyes were like flame of fire, and on his head was crowns, and he had a name written, one that no one knew except himself. And he had be clothed in a garment, dipped in blood, and his name is called the Word of God. And the armies in heaven followed him on the white horses, clothed in fine linen, white and clean. And out of his mouth goes a sharp sword, so that with it he should strike the nations. And he will shepherd them with a rod of iron, and he treadeth with winepress of the wine and the anger and of wrath of Almighty God. And he has on his garment and on his thigh a name written, King of Kings and the Lord of Lords. And I saw one angel standing in the sun, and he cried with a great voice, saying to all the birds that fly in the midst heaven, Come and gather together to the supper of the great God, so that you may eat the flesh of kings and the flesh of commanders, and the flesh of strong ones, and the flesh of horses, and those sitting on them, and the flesh of all, both free and slave, both small and great. And I saw the beast and the kings of the earth and their army being gathered to make the war against him who sat on a horse and against his army. And the beast was taken, and with him the false prophet, doing signs before it, by which he deceived those who had received the mark of the beast, and those who had worshipped his image. The two were thrown alive into the lake of fire, burning with brimstone. And the rest were slain by the sword of him who sat on the horse, it proceeding out of his mouth. And all the birds were filled from their flesh. And the armies in heaven followed him on white horses, clothed in fine linen, white and clean. Yeshua HaMashiach, Jesus Christ, the Lion of Judah, will come with his heavenly army of the redeemed ones. The army of God is made of two major parts. One is angelic being led by Michael the Archangel, and the other is his people who were redeemed from the earth, who are clothed in the clean white linen, their heavenly clothes. The army of redeemed people consists of different groups in very strict hierarchy. The role of angels of this war is to battle against their enemies, the fallen angelic beings. The redeemed ones will wage war against the Nephilim and half-breeds. The redeemed ones who will be fighting in this war are preparing right now. When the first resurrection of the dead occurs, the separation between the two realms, physical and spiritual, will begin to gradually fade away. From this moment there will be many wonderful signs in heaven and on the earth when people will witness the manifestation of the spiritual realm. Evil entities will also be manifesting and terrifying people on the earth. I would like to address the controversy surrounding the so-called rapture. One group of believers accept a pre-trib rapture while another hold to a post-trib rapture. There is no such a thing that a pre- or post-trib rapture. There is the age of the first resurrection and transformation. It will start from the resurrection from the dead of all righteous people who live from Adam until the certain appointed day in the future, and the transformation of Yeshua's bride into their new glorified bodies. Those still alive who are part of his bride and ready to meet their bridegroom will be part of this event. It will signal the beginning of the end of the kingdom of darkness and the start of the establishment of the millennium kingdom. When the armies of the redeemed ones receive the glorified bodies, they will be ready to fight the kingdom of darkness with great strength and power because they now inhabit a new spiritual body. A clue about this event can be read in Revelation. After this thing I looked, and behold, a door was open in heaven, and the first voice which I heard was, as it were, of trumpet, talking with me, saying, Come up here, and I will show you what must occur after these things. Come up here refers to resurrection, as we see in another verse in the Revelation. There are the two olive trees and the two lampstands standing before the God of the earth. And when they complete their testimony, the beast coming up out of the abyss will make war against them and will overcome them and kill them. And their body will lie in the street of the great city, which spiritually is called Sodom and Egypt, where also our Lord was crucified. And many of the peoples and tribes and tongues and nations will see their dead bodies 3 days and a half, and they will not allow their dead body to put in tombs. And after 3 days and a half, a spirit of life from God entered into them, and they stood on their feet, and great fear fell on those seeing them, and they heard a great voice from heaven saying to them, Come up here, and they went up to heaven in a cloud. And their enemies watch them. The two witnesses are resurrected and taken away from the earth up to heaven in the cloud. This event happens just before the seventh trumpet of Revelation, which opened the judgment of the seven vials. The third time, the resurrection of the dead in their glorified bodies will happen after the coming of the Messiah on the earth. and they sat throne, and they sat on them, and judgment was given to them. And they saw the souls of those who had been beheaded for the witness of Jesus, and for the word of God, and who had not worshipped the beast, not his image, nor had received his mark on their foreheads, nor in their hands. And they lived and reigned with Christ 1,000 years. But the rest of the dead did not live again until the 1,000 years were finished. This is the first resurrection. Blessed and holy is he who has part in the first resurrection. The second death has no authority over this, but they will be priests of God and of Christ and will reign with him 1,000 years. What about the people who are going to live during the millennium kingdom? What part of the resurrection will the righteous people at that time be part of? First or second? In the verse above, we see that only unrepented sinners are entering to the second resurrection. Therefore, the first resurrection is not one-time event. By the beginning of the millennium reign of Yeshua HaMashiach, who is the resurrection and the life. Scriptures say that during the millennium kingdom, people will live a long life, as a tree, for many hundreds of years. Death during this time will be a curse for the person. Only those who are unrepentant and rebellious against God will die during the millennium. No child will die in infancy. Everyone will live to ripe of old age. Anyone 100 years old will be considered young, and to die younger than that will be considered a curse. But those who are righteous are going to be transferred into their glorified bodies at their appointed times, when their time on the earth has been fulfilled and Yeshua himself will greet them into his new Jerusalem. Therefore, we live in the time when the trumpet of the Lord will call his people out of the earth to stand together against the satanic army and become the mighty army of God. When Satan will gather his army against God's army in the battle of Armageddon, it will be a final battle of the king who will come ahead of his army to finish off the demonic and evil forces in his glorious appearance. He will fight them with the sword that proceeds from his mouth and as a spoken word. The light and the power of his word will not spare any of the wicked who are facing his judgment. Therefore, I will proclaim, repent, the kingdom of heaven is at hand.